why I'm glad the space shuttle blew up. No! It wasn't the classroom full of school kids on TV, whimpering in horror, trying to stomach what they just seen on the screen. Each one of them still wearing one of those pointed birthday hats. No! Our first reaction in my house was each of us sitting around and daring each other to call up the San Francisco Examiner and say we were that legendary Libyan hit squad you've heard so much about, and we blew up the space shuttle. Late that night, we gave up the idea. Same old excuse. What if we get caught? Sometimes, though, it really does make sense just to chicken out. But now I find out we were pretty damn lucky. If that shuttle had made it home, things might now be a hell of a lot worse. Cause NASA had this little plan for the following space shuttle they somehow forgot to tell us about. They had this plan to send the next shuttle into orbit carrying 46 pounds of plutonium. If that one had blown up, there'd be enough radiation scattered in our atmosphere to cause cancer in as many as 5 billion people! How reckless can you get? How reckless can you get? Up, up and away! Launch Star Wars the easy way! Just fire it up into the great beyond and don't tell anybody about it. After all, when people don't know what hurts them, they don't care. Just blame the fallout cancer epidemic on Gaddafi. Think of all the money people we know and love would make selling how to cope with cancer kits to BAM readers and yuppies. That's why I'm glad the space shuttle blew up. Because the next one would have cooked all of us, too.